Hey everybody, I'm Sosastic and welcome on this new video. You have been a lot of people asking me for a new Lion King family tree video, and for Christmas I'm happy to present you the fourth part of the Lion King family tree. Rocco recognized Mist. She definitely was the lost princess of Pride Rock. He told her a bit more about himself and about the Pride Lands. He told her how Jinx was. At first, she wasn't believing him. Her brother was the softest lion ever. He could have never changed into a monster like Rocco pictured him. As she was ready to leave, Rocco convinced her to come with him to the Pride Lands, so she could see by herself how her brother was. She accepted. Anyway, she needed him. Staying alone would be her death, because she couldn't hunt. And not being able to hunt means getting no food. No food means death. Their travel just began. Meanwhile, in the Central Park Zoo, the people decided to send Kito back to the wildlife, because after what happened to the circus with Mist and Fang, the men took the decision to free all originally wild animals. Alake, who got named Alex, became the king of New York. And after years of hope, Kito finally could walk through the African lands again, even though he still needed to do something. He needed to find Ashi, the only lioness he ever loved. As they were traveling to Pride Land, they one day met a rogue lion. Mist noticed him because she heard someone singing. Colmek was a cool lion. He liked having fun singing and not to worry. He enjoyed living. Life was a great adventure for him. He was a joyful lion, but Rocco didn't trust him. He was too cool to be real. Mist was intrigued by this new lion who had introduced him as Skylar. This name made Rocco laugh. The dark lion was a lot sarcastic around Skylar. In fact, Skylar's real name was Colmek, but he chose Skylar like a stage name. To Rocco, he was pathetic and ridiculous. Mist didn't agree with Rocco. Actually, she liked Colmek and offered him to come with them, which didn't make Rocco happy, but he had no choice. His mission was to take Mist back to the Pride Lands, and if it meant to be with Colmek, then he would deal with it. The old lion walked for days, hoping Ashi would still be where they used to live together before Kito got captured. After a long travel, he finally reached their little hideaway. When he got in, he found nothing. Maybe Ashi died after all these years. Or maybe she found another place, a clan, another male. Kito laid down on a rock, hopeless. But after a few minutes, a young lioness entered the lair. She growled at the male, asking him who he was and why he was in her cave. Kito quickly got up and apologized. He asked if she knew where the lioness who lived there before was now. And at that, the young lioness raised a brow, confused. In the same time, an older lioness entered. It was Ashi. She was alive. Kito's heart skipped a beat as he couldn't believe it. Ashi got shocked to see him back. She asked if he really was a lion before rushing to him. She never gave up her hope to see him coming back. She waited for him all these years. She then introduced Saphira, their daughter. She explained him that when he got captured, she found out she was pregnant, and a few months later, this little lioness was born. Kito couldn't believe this. This was probably the most happy day of his life. Him and Ashi lived happily together for the rest of their lives. The more they traveled, the closer Mist got with Colmek. They told each other about their lives. As a cub, Colmec been saved and raised by humans. This is why he loved humans a lot, which pissed Rocco off. How could he love humans this much? To the Dark Lion, it made no sense, but to Colmec, it made a lot of sense. Humans have been good with him, and without them, he would have died. Mist found Rocco pretty unfair with Colmec. To her, the Dark Lion was mean because he was probably jealous. Colmec noticed that Mist couldn't hunt, and offered her to teach her how to hunt. Of course, she accepted. With him, it was a lot of fun. Mist even started to like to sing. They were really happy together. Jealous, Rocco decided to teach Mist how to fight, so he could spend time with her as well. The three lions traveled for days and finally reached the Pride Lands. It was a lot of emotion for Mist when she saw the Pride Rock. It was like in her dreams. She thought she would never be able to see it ever again. Rocco warned Mist and Colmec about Jinx and his cursed lion. When Colmec understood they were about to get in a war, he found a stupid excuse to leave and disappeared. No way he was going to fight for a pride he wasn't even a part of. This decision disappointed Mist a lot, and Rocco told her he knew Colmec was too perfect to be real. Without Skylar, Mist and Rocco finally reached the Pride Rock. There, they found Sharp and Fleck group ready for an attack. She stopped them and offered her help. Her talking to her brother could probably ease everything without having to fight. But Sharp refused, and with his panther, they ran to the rock to attack the prince. The war began. The panthers were fast, and Jinx's lion was strong. Rocco stopped Mist from joining the fight to protect her, but the lioness growled at him, telling him she was tired of people telling her what she can or can't do. Her whole life, she has been said what to do, and this wasn't going to continue here. On that, she ran to her brother. At the same time, Colmec came back to help. He couldn't leave Mist and Rocco. Even if he didn't like to fight, he had to help them. When Jinx saw his sister running to him, it was like in a dream, and this made him lose his concentration, giving Fleck the opportunity to attack the evil lion and hurt him badly. Her lioness rushed to her brother, who collapsed on the ground. His reign of terror was over. Injured and defeated, Jinx got immediately banned from Pride Lands. Mist tried to talk to Fleck, but Jinx accepted his fate. Once he would get better, he would have to leave the land and never come back. Until then, he was allowed to stay around the elephant graveyard under the surveillance of Rocco. Mist took the decision to leave in the same time as her brother to create her own pride. Everybody understood her choice, and Fleck became the king since Inja got killed in the war. Sharp left the Pride Lands to return to the jungle. He took with him his brother, Nash, and a lioness he fell for a while ago and who loved him back. Unlike Sharp, Nash never found any mate, and his roar never came back. But his experience in the different wars he went in helped him to form the new panthers and lions of the wild. The wilds became somehow the army of the Pride Lands. Linus got banned from the Pride Land as well as Jinx. Why Linus got banned? Because he never tried to stop what was going on, or tried to talk to Inja when he could have. He let bad things happen. And to Fleck, he wasn't better than his son. Linus waited with Jinx. And when the day had come, the two lions left the Pride Lands together. Nobody ever heard about any of them. With Flake as the new king, the Pride Lands would be safe as when Simba was king. So this was the fourth part of the Lion King family tree. And I have a question for you guys. Would you like to either continue on this series, or we could see a little series of video only based on Fang, the tiger from the circus, or we could also make a series of video on Mist Cub. So you would see our lions, Fleck, Sharp, Nash, Mist, Rocco, and all the other lions, but under the adventure of their cubs. You have three possibilities. You tell me, you choose. So I just wanted to tell you guys that I decided to post every Tuesday a gaming video. So be on my channel every Tuesday for a new video. I wanted to ask you, because I got suggested to do that, to create a series of video based on the Harry Potter or Fantastic Beasts universe. And I might have a little idea what I could do. So if you are interested in this, you tell me if you'd like to see that. That was a lot of information, that was a lot of news, but I try to improve my channel so you can have more video coming out on my channel. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this new Lion King family tree. If you did, don't forget to leave a like on this video. Also, you can share with your friend. You can comment and tell me whatever you want to tell me in the comments. You can also subscribe my channel if you want more videos. And don't forget to smash this notification bell, because I want to hear it ring so loud. And on that, guys, it was Celestastic, and I'm gonna see you soon for another video. Bye bye and take care.